ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कांटो 10 चैप्टर नंबर 13 एंड टेक्स्ट नंबर 38। ब्रह्मा स्टीलिंग द बॉयज एंड काउस। दिस इज ब्रह्म विमोहन लीला ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा। द टाइटल इज ब्रह्म विमोहन, बट राइट नाउ वी आर इन द वर्स दैट लॉर्ड बलराम इज ऑल्सो गेटिंग बिविल्डर, सो व्हाट टू स्पीक। द ऑटोक्रेसी ऑफ लॉर्ड श्री कृष्णा इज अनसरपासेबल by any of his expansions. That's why he is the supreme autocrat, and he has been talked about. He may be known by so many different nomenclatures, but somehow or another he is so much exceptionally described in Srimad Bhagavatam as the supreme personality of Godhead, who is everything. Aham sarvasya prabhavo mattah sarvam pravartate iti matva bhajante mam buddha bhava samanvita. So we are trying to become buddha bhava in order to understand his the supremacy of the Lord. So the text number goes like that: iti sanchintya dasharho vatsan savayasan napi sarvan achasta vaikuntham चक्षुषा वयुनेन सह। इति संचिन्त्य दाशार्हो वत्सान सवयसानपि सर्वान् चष्ट वैकुण्ठम् चक्षुषा वयुनेन सह। इति संचिन्त्य दाशार्हो वत्सान सवयसानपि सर्वान चष्ट वैकुण्ठम् चक्षुषा वयुनेन सह। इति संचिन्त्य दाशार्हो वत्सान सवयसानपि सर्वान चष्ट वैकुण्ठम् चक्षुषा वयुनेन सह। इति संचिन्त्य, थिंकिंग इन दिस वे, दाशार्ह बलदेव, बत्सान द काउस, सह वयसान अलोंग विथ हिज कंपेनियंस, अपि ऑल्सो सर्वान ऑल आचस्ट, सो वैकुंठम एस श्री कृष्ण ओनली, चक्षुषा वयनेन with the eyes of transcendental knowledge, saha he baladev. Translation and purport by his divine grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Thinking in this way, Lord Balaram was able to see with the eyes of transcendental knowledge that all these cows and Krishna's friends were expansions of the form of Sri Krishna. Every individual is different. There are even differences between the twin brothers. Yet when Krishna expanded himself as the boys and the calves, each boy and each calf appear in its own original feature, with the same individual way of acting, the same tendency, and the same color, and the same dress, and so on. For Krishna manifested himself with all these differences. This was Krishna's opulence. Om Ajnanati Mirantasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshul Militan Jena Tasmai Sri Gurve Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobishtam Sthapitam Jena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamahyam Dadati Svapadantikam Vandeham Sri Guruho Sri Juta Padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatham Vitamtam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakhanvitamscha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Deena Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Sri Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Namaha Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamin Niti Namine Namaste Sarasate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Desatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare Iti Sanchintya Dasharho Vatsana Savaya Sanapi Sarvana Chastra Vaikuntham Chakshusha Vayunena Saha. Thinking in this way, Lord Balaram was able to see with the eyes of transcendental knowledge that all these cows and Krishna's friends were expansions of the form of Krishna. Balaram was thinking in the previous chapter that has been described here also that all these cows and Krishna's friends were expansions of the form of Krishna. How did he come to this conclusion? Balaram knows that this is not the activity of Maya. Otherwise, there won't be any difficulty for him to understand these expansions. Balaram is the first body of Lord Krishna. Is identical, but he is appearing as a servitor of Krishna. That is an amazing thing. All his expansions are for the purpose of serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Shri Krishna alone. Ekale Ishwar Krishna ar sabhi bratya. Jahara Icha ke tabhi nachahe nritya. Is the total transcendental autocrat personality of Godhead, the single moiety, the supreme moiety, from whom, by whose desires, his internal potencies are working. Upanishads are telling that before you know the personality, you have to know the qualities. The qualities, when they are manifested, then the personality will manifest. But without knowing the qualities, how would you know the personality? The Upanishads are describing the single moiety only. Even in impersonal way or in incognito, न च तस्य कारणम, तस्य इज यू कैन इंटरप्रिट एनीबॉडी, तस्य मीन्स हुज, न तदस्य कारणम करणम च विद्यते, न तत समासम अधिकच्च दृश्यते, पराश शक्तिर विविधि श्रूयते, स्वाभाविक ही ज्ञान बल क्रिया च. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस स्वभाव? फॉर द सुप्रीम एब्सोल्यूट, इफ यू वांट टू नो हिम देन यू शुड नो दैट देयर इज नो कॉज फॉर हिम एंड नथिंग ही हैज टू एवर टू डू एनीथिंग. And therefore, this position of the absolute truth is very unique, and nobody can compete it. Therefore, nobody is equal to or greater than him. Na chata samasam abhi adhikachya drashyate. Adhika means superior. So, Upanishad says, parash shakti. That Supreme Absolute, who is the transcendental moiety, whom we are discussing about, swabhaviki jnana balakriyacha. His qualities are manifested through his swabhav. Swabhav means, swa means his own nature. Nature means qualities. And they manifest in jnana bala kriyacha. So manifestation of the potencies are very important to recognize the personality. Without potency exhibited by anybody, you cannot recognize him. Srila Prabhupada has transcendental potency and you recognize him only on that basis. Is not an ordinary person. Transcendental potency, swabhav. Swabhav is an integrated quality which is embedded in the personality, and whatever he does out of not normal behavior. Therefore, Vaishnavas are supposed to be on that platform. And we should not estimate the kriya mudra. Kriya means activities, and mudra means his manifested nature. Na pujiya, vigna ne apujiya. However you want to study materially, what they call, physical nature, somatic or genetic attributes, they are not capable to understand that personality. So Vaishnavera Kriya Mudra Vignaniya Bhujiya. So what to speak of Lord Balaram? And he is getting bewildered. So what to speak of Lord Krishna? We go that way. That is the sequential approach. Unless and until Krishna expands himself to the minutest level as Paramatma in our heart, he will never infuse even the life symptoms of a living entity. So we are in a borrowed situation. Everything is borrowed. Materially, everything is borrowed. We never brought anything. And consciously also, we have borrowed the potency from the Paramatma. Unless and until Krishna is reaching out so expandedly in this material world, we can't know even ourselves. However you try. And it is the desire of individual that is existing when we are rekindled with the desire of the Lord. And yet we want to rebel. How can we understand him? Yeah. So we have to become in tune in a very disciplined way to understand the reversal of the entire of creation. How did everything get created in the first place? And Krishna, the supreme autocrat, instantly, you know, he can expand himself into as many calves and cowherd boys that Brahma stole. It didn't take much time for Brahma to steal, fine. But he was away for 1 year totally and kept everybody encaved in the cave of the hill and put up a stone so they cannot get out even. So Krishna took the opportunity. As soon as Brahma vanished, he expanded and he kept on activity as it was before. And such expansions are so wonderful that the influence of Krishna's presence in each and every cowherd boy in their original feature back, that even their parents were completely bewildered, but only difference is there. They accepted they are the same as their children. The cows also thought the same as their cows. But somehow or other there was a great difference of love. They were attracted. Everybody is physically attracted with their progeny. But spiritual attraction means attraction of such unfathomable love can be only understood on the loving aspect of a devotee only, how he tries to understand. So Lord Balaram also got bewildered, but he says, how can this Maya escape from my knowledge that I cannot recognize that? It must be Krishna himself. He comes to the conclusion that nobody beats the desire of my Lord. I have come as an elder brother, but yet I am a servant of him and I love him. He is the cause of my appearance. He's my master. Even though elder can think out of love that they are subservient. Elder thinks that they are subservient. So this is the transcendental truth that we have to accept. So we have to incorporate in our behavior also. Everybody is my master. I am their servant. Simply giving a title of servant president or servant of the devotees, and they are trying to change the titles. That is not enough. Behavior. If Balaram has to come to this particular behavior to know Krishna, then what to speak of us? Balaram comes to understand by logical conclusion. According to him, for us it is spiritual conclusion. Because Balaram was expanded spiritually from Krishna. So that transcendental expansion is unlimited. From Balaram, so many things expanded. The first Chaturvyuha expanded. Vasudeva, Sankarsana, Pratyumna, Aniruddha. People don't understand that part also. The, what is the necessary or necessity to expand in Goloka Vrindavan? But the Vedic principle is that Eko Bahushyam. One manifested in men. It doesn't mean many are one. Many are individuals. They have been given a chance because they have been separated, eternally separated. They may be part and parcel, but they are transcendentally becoming part and parcel, not physically. However you try by negating as an impersonalist, however you try by becoming Mayavadi to connect and replace even Krishna and become Krishna yourself. But no, that is not transcendental reality. It exposes by Mahamaya. It is smashed. Lord Shiva is there to smash our false ego. Everybody, Krishna's expansion, they are there to give us full protections, full shelter, and full nourishment. So never to worry those who are trying to take the shelter of Krishna alone. Then we have to come to this conclusion that Lord Balaram thinks, we say there is no esoteric even difference between Krishna and Balaram. They are one and the same. Balaram is considered to be the second body of Krishna. Only color difference. We may think of the physical differences. Otherwise, both love each other so intimate that you don't find any quarrel between them. Or there is some displeasure, of course. But as a servant, it is mitigated immediately. You know the story of Krishna desired that now Duryodhan has to be finished. Duryodhan was the student of Balaram. But when he knew the desire of Krishna, he gave up every hope for making Duryodhan victorious. And under the pretext of pilgrimage, he left. And Krishna, who is the mastermind, everything, he yielded to his desire. So, in this way, Balaram obeyed Krishna's desire. Apparently, you see displeasure, but there is no displeasure. One can play the role of a spiritual master for a notorious character like Duryodhan. Balaram was the spiritual master for that. And yet he was supposed to be smashed by Krishna himself. So where should be resistant? Here we try to negotiate in material world. Hey, spare him this way, that way, you know. We play so many politics to interact this way and that way, thinking everybody is saying. We try to bargain the positions. Where is the necessity? So, Balaram came to the conclusion, said, this is my original nature, that I am subservient to Krishna, even though I have come before Krishna physically. But there is, in spirituality, physics means existential truth, but spiritually, existential truth. And it is the function of Balaram. Function of the Balaram to make everything manifest physically. Even Golok Vrindavan has been manifested physically. Means it is truth, but that physics is spiritual in nature. Sahastrapatra Kamalam Sahastrakyam Mahatpadam Tat Karnikaram Tat Dhamam Tat Anantamsha Sambhavam. Who is the manifester of Golok Vrindavan, which is described in Brahma Sanhita right after Ishvara Paramakrishna. So Balaram knows. He's the Sandini potency and Samvit combined. He knows his Adi Guru, he is the manifestation. So Guru has to manifest the characteristic of subserviency. He may be called Lord and Master for the disciples, but unless and until he serves his disciples and bring to the, at least this understanding that is given in the Shastra, if Balaram can develop that, why not we? So Balaram thinks, it must be Lord Krishna's direct intervention, and he can do anything. Lord Krishna himself expanded into all these calves and cowherd boys so that this atmosphere of extreme love has been created between the parents, the cows, the bulls, the gopas and gopis, the parents of the cowherd boys. They recognize that they are mine, they are the same. They didn't have any observation of a difference in behavior. Krishna can play exactly and make others to play exactly as he wants. These are all Narayan. And Balaram knew. Only for the pleasure of Brahma, when Brahma inquires, Krishna is exhibiting them. For the pleasure of Brahma. And Brahma was a bewildered person. And how it is written that it's for the pleasure of Brahma and all his intimate devotees who came to observe the depth of love Krishna is exhibiting this particular leela. Brahma gets bewildered, fine, because he is a materialistic man and in mode of passion. So naturally, when a person who is so much industrious in physical activity, even by the physical yogic power, he can make everybody disappear or bring in forth, whatever it is, gets bewildered by the transcendental nature. You can't, with a limited understanding, make or able to measure the limits of unlimited. These are the Vedic truths, and we have to accept, and we try to take into account that these are not too difficult to understand. As there is the side of Maya, Mahamaya, there is also the side of Antaranga Maya, internal potency, and which is said to be 3/4 in estimation. I don't say size or this or that, but estimation. So if we are getting some kind of a limited experience of the activity that are bewildering us in ordinary circumstances also, then what to speak of at the level of Brahma, he can also get bewildered. But the transcendental potency does not have any limits. So to measure the limits of the transcendental activity is what you call a shortcoming of a feeble mind. He gets immediately defeated. So Brahma got defeated and he came to beg forgiveness. But at that time, Brahma did not know how this bewilderment was caused. But Balaram knew. He came to the conclusion by his loving attitude. Brahma didn't have love from this child Krishna. Love is more intimate in any relationship. It becomes so strong that Krishna reciprocates exactly in the same way. So when Balaram knew that here it is Krishna, Krishna must be smiling. Now you came to know. Okay, good. Keep it with you because I want to surprise Brahma yet. Balaram glorifies Lord Krishna. When proper understanding is coming, Balaram himself glorifies the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Because it's only glorification is the only medium for everyone to understand the spiritual potency of the Superior. Therefore, it is customary to glorify the devotees. If we do not glorify the devotees, then we do not know anything about them. But Balaram shows us that glorification to Krishna is most important. So he was also bewildered, but by deliberation of his own spiritual potency, he came to the conclusion on his own. He is my master. He is the cause. He is the one who did it himself. He would have known even, because the Narayan forms that Krishna brought in place of every cows and cowherd boys, we see it is for Brahma. But Balaram knew that these are all my expansion. Even they are my expansion. I didn't know that Krishna can cause them to appear. All the Narayan forms were shown to Brahma. These are my expansions. But actually, Balaram is the second body, and he didn't know that Krishna made me expand. So that is the real bewilderment. He acknowledges this. He's such a master. Krishna's mastery over anything that be. It's very, very sobering to our mind, words, and intelligence, or whatever we express ourselves through. We see how exactness that Krishna expanded himself in each and every detail of every single cowherd boy and calves. That parents are recognizing that they are their children, but they are not able to understand how come we are so much attracted by them. In Vrindavan, everybody has desire, all the elderlies, in the relation of parental love. All the elderly, they were desiring Krishna to be their child. Therefore, even though they knew that it's Nanda Baba and Yashoda Mata's child, but yet they were loving in the same aspect of parental love. And Krishna, in this way, fulfilling their desires to be their child, factually. Only by undivided love I can be known as I am. Bhaktya mam abhijanati javanaschashmi tatvatah tato mam tatvato gyatva vishate tadantaram. Only by undivided devotional service, means love, can I be known as I am. Standing before you, Arjuna, not only that you know me in truth, but you will be able to see me in truth, and you will be able to enter into my intricate loving exchanges in truth. So, this is a very great understanding in the purport that we see through the behavior of Balaram. Why Balaram has to become subordinate? Subordination is required for protection, for maintenance, for even our individuality. Everything is required for us. Otherwise, what is the shelter? People tried, occupied the whole planet Earth for many, many years to live in the early times of in Brahma's creation. They were called Samrat, king of the whole world, and yet they can't manage. They have to give up. Many became appreciated as caretakers only, but they cannot be whole and soul proprietor like Lord Shri Krishna. So, in this way we will see how Balaram is explaining his thinking, so we can emulate. The next verse has a bigger purport, and probably I'm stealing half of the understanding from it, so don't worry. So, anybody has any question or comments on this? Jai Prabhuji.
We hear that Balaram is bewildered, and sometimes Krishna says, "I'm bewildered about going in Agasura's mouth." And they voluntarily accept that bewilderment and can free themselves from that bewilderment at any time. And maybe we just chose to be bewildered, and we're bewildered by choice as well.
We did not choose bewilderment.
But Balaram and Krishna, when they're bewildered, is it a self-imposed bewilderment, or is it something that's just part of Leela, Krishna's playing Leela and multi-personality?
That's correct. Bewilderment has two purposes. One, to exhibit ignorance, and second thing is to enthuse the transcendental joy.
Krishna initiates that illusion himself and puts himself in illusion and presses the button and gets rid of it, or how does it go?
No, real bewilderment will give us transcendental joy. Those who are following in this spiritual path and transcendental nature is understood, then it will be joyful that this bewilderment has been a tool in order to increase our love of Godhead. But in material world, the bewilderment itself is so much nothing but ignorance, that nobody is bewildered by his own foolishness. Is there anybody enjoying their foolishness? No. Yeah, many a time such mistakeful ignorance or inalertness would put us in an imitation, joyful condition. If you walk on the street and somehow or other the car is coming and you try to cross, and if you make it, then you say, aha, look, I am victorious. It's an artificial joy, it is clear. I beat up that car. People smile at the time of death even, but that is in ignorance. And they do not go back home, back to Godhead by smiling. They are caught. But people think that they escaped. So then they see, look, nobody can beat me. Politics is like that. If somebody is superior and mastermind and put somebody else into charge and gives him the onus of, becoming a scapegoat, or use him. And he thinks, look at that, I use somebody to save myself. I'm smart, isn't it? Yeah, people use like that. So the idea is that material bewilderment is escapism from the reality. Krishna outsmarts everybody. Jai, shed the light on this.
I really appreciated how you said that Krishna is the transcendental absolute God. That was amazing. And also you briefly touched on Srila Prabhupada's consciousness also, how he acts and behaves in a way we fully understood. You mentioned it briefly also. Mm. What's the name of this movie? Tell me about this translation of the screen. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, so it appears in this translation that Balaram was able to see with the eye of transcendental knowledge, which is sort of supporting also Panchakota Prabhu's inquiry further. So when we say open beyond the Tibetan, the second and dimensional time, so we're coming out of the darkness of ignorance through the thoughts that have knowledge given by the disciplines, essentially. So from Mahamaya transitioning into being influenced by Yoga Maya. But that's not the case of Balaram, because there's no idea here. There's no ignorance here. So can you just explain in my limitations of this? I mean, there's a lot of limitations for me in this. Can you just explain how Balaram is losing his transcendental cowardliness to come down to recognize this in relationship to Krishna?
Yeah, if you see the previous verse, the explanation is given. It is not instantly Balaram knew, but Balaram went through the process of transcendental knowledge that he had. First, he thought of some maybe other reason, but it is not how could it. Then he counteracts those reasoning, because of the superior understanding. So ultimate conclusion that Balaram comes is then it should be only Krishna. How? Balaram was surprised. This extraordinary show of affection, he thought was something mystical, performed either by the demigods or some wonderful men. Otherwise, how could this wonderful change take place? This Maya might be some Rakshasi Maya. He thought, but how can Rakshasi Maya have any influence upon me? Balaram says, this is not possible. Therefore, it must be Maya of Krishna. Right? Thus, he concluded that the mystical change must have been caused by Krishna, whom Balaram considers his worshipable personality of Godhead. That finishes. So, appropriate behavior of Balaram is exhibited by glorifying Krishna, coming to the conclusion that Krishna is the cause of all causes.
So then would it safely come to the point of saying that sometimes the eternal associates, they may really lose their eternality as the cowboy boy to come to this conclusion? Like Balaram's.
And then the bewilderment has to take its own thing.
Yes.
It is for the pleasure. Why Krishna wants you to tease you? For his own pleasure. Why Krishna wants to put you into difficulty? For his own pleasure, that you can surrender more and more to him. Yasya aham anugrahanami harishya taddhanam sanehi. Because you are a devotee, he wants to extract more and more from you, the whole sum of you. Why are you so much conjuiced that you give only little? That is his enjoyment. But real enjoyment is that nature. Here, our enjoyment in Prabhupada's time is that Prabhupada was so caring that he would chastise somebody and the rest of the devotees say, "You got the sauce." And they were enjoying it. And we were told that, "Prabhu, the sauce is the real thing that is enjoyable. It is the mercy of Krishna is coming." And that's how Srila Prabhupada would say. Now, who is there here? We don't even appreciate sauces in this time, isn't it? So that is the situation. Spice in the sauce, not sweet sauce.
Thank you, that was wonderful.
Hare Krishna. Yeah. Can you pass the mic, please?
Thank you so much for explaining this. I've been lost in a simple manner. Okay. Out of the universe. So, the Adi Guru is subject to bewilderment. That is the case. Our spiritual masters also subject to bewilderment. And in case the spiritual master undergoes the bewilderment, it does not mean that the bewilderment as similar as the conditioned soul. Is it different?
Spiritual master bewilderment is for himself, not for his disciples. Otherwise, we will become like Ramchandra Puri.
Thank you.
It's a relishment of the pure devotee, and the disciple considers it to be wrong, and that the whole thing was completely out of the realm of spiritual life. Don't disturb your spiritual master if he's showing some kind of, you know, bewilderment in Krishna consciousness. Let him relish and he will come, because a sincere soul is always dear to Krishna. If it is something fishy, then let his god brothers take care of him. Why do you have to? I mean, why does a disciple has to get into anybody else? Yes, Prabhu, can you pass there all the way down? Is too esoteric. You better get into Chaitanya Charitamrita thoroughly. And before you enter into Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami takes help of Rupa Goswami and Laghu Bhagavatamritam and clearing up the position of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. These are so intimate, even in esoteric nature. But to speak of Leela nature, they are more and more deeper. I am not qualified, Prabhu, sorry, I am a wrong number.
My apologies, Maharaj.
Hare Krishna. Anything else? Thank you very much, Prabhupada.